My dear friends, today I'll be discussing about the various complications of mitral stenosis. Now, what is mitral stenosis? Mitral stenosis means stenosis of the mitral valve, which is present on the left atrioventricular aperture. So it is one of the common cause of valvular heart disease, and sometimes it may also leads to life-threatening situation, and it may even leads to acute stroke or cerebrovascular accident also. So today we'll discuss about various complications of mitral stenosis. Now, one of the important cause of mitral stenosis is rheumatic heart disease or rheumatic fever, and it is common in any age after a rheumatic heart disease or after years of rheumatic heart disease or rheumatic fever. It may be because of that. Besides, there may be associated mitral valve calcification. The size of the mitral valve is normally 4 to 6 cm². When the mitral surface area or orifice become less than 2 cm², we can define it as a mitral stenosis or narrowing of the orifice of the mitral valve of the heart. And when the aperture size becomes less than 1 cm², the sign symptoms becomes very prominent, as well as the risk of complication or chance of complication also gradually increases. When it comes to diagnosis, echocardiography is the diagnostic tool of choice, and Doppler echocardiography can focus on the transmitral gradient, which is an important parameter to focus on the severity of the disease. Transmitral gradient, or difference between the left atrial and left ventricular pressure, is an important parameter which can reflect on the severity of the disease. Besides, the size of the left atrium or left atrial pressure is another important parameter which also reflect the severity of the mitral stenosis. There are severe various type of sign symptoms of the disease. Dyspnea on exertion or shortness of breath, or paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, orthopnea, etc., are the most common sign symptoms of mitral stenosis. Besides, in case of severe disease, when there is left atrial enlargement compressing the esophagus, then there may be risk of or sign symptom of dysphagia. Then hemoptysis may be there. Then sometimes sign symptoms of right heart failure and right ventricular failure can be seen. Besides, if there is atrial fibrillation, then sign symptoms of atrial fibrillation can be seen also in some patients. So these are the various sign symptoms of the disease, that is mitral stenosis. And when it comes to treatment, there are several treatment policies like percutaneous mitral valvuloplasty, which is done with the help of balloon catheter. Then there is surgical treatment or total correction of the mitral valve, which is replacement with the prosthetic heart valve or prosthetic mitral valve, and which needs lifelong anticoagulation as well as treatment checkup, regular checkups, because at the same time there are some medical management also. And for asymptomatic patients, treatment is not allowed, or there is treatment or management is not necessary for those who are not symptomatic or who are asymptomatic. Now we'll discuss about the various complications of mitral stenosis. Now, as we know, mitral stenosis leads to the defect in blood flow or abnormal blood flow because of narrowing of the mitral valvular orifice, and that's why blood from the left atrium cannot enter into the left ventricle. So there is a gradual accumulation of blood in the left atrium, which increase the left atrial pressure, and because of the left atrial pressure rise, there is a left atrial enlargement, so which ultimately leads to left atrial hypertrophy. So one of the most common complication of mitral stenosis is left atrial hypertrophy. Left atrial hypertrophy occurs because left atrial enlargement, because of gradual rise of the left atrial pressure, and that is because of high transmitral gradient, that is depend on the severity of the mitral stenosis. More severe is the stenosis if the aperture become less than 1 cm², then blood from the left atrium cannot enter into the left ventricle during the diastolic phase of the cardiac cycle. And that's why there is gradual accumulation of the blood in the left atrium, even at the end of diastole. And gradually, with the more accumulation of blood in the left atrium, there is a regular rise of pressure of the left atrium, which ultimately responsible for left atrial enlargement, which ultimately leads to left atrial hypertrophy. So left atrial hypertrophy as well as left atrial enlargement, these are the various complications of mitral stenosis. Besides, as the left atrial enlargement and left atrial pressure remains very high or persistently high, it can lead to pulmonary hypertension through back pressure. So high pressure in the left atrium give a back pressure on the pulmonary veins, and through back pressure theory it increases the pressure of the pulmonary capillaries as well as pulmonary arteries, and because of that there is a rise of pulmonary blood pressure, which causes pulmonary hypertension. Now pulmonary hypertension, if it persists for long time, increase the capillary hydrostatic pressure of the pulmonary capillaries, and finally which leads to rupture of the pulmonary capillaries, and it may leads to hemoptysis or coughing out of blood. At the same time there is accumulation of fluid into the alveoli, so which leads to pulmonary edema. So pulmonary edema, pulmonary hypertension, hemoptysis, so these are various complications of mitral stenosis. Besides, if the pulmonary hypertension persists for long time, then right ventricle has to pump the blood against that high pressure resistant, and because of that there is a right ventricular hypertrophy. The musculature of the right ventricle become very thick because it has to overwork against a strong resistant, and gradually because of the pressure overload there is a hypertrophy of the right ventricle. So there is another complication of mitral stenosis, right ventricular hypertrophy, and that's why we can find parasternal heap in physical examination of the chest or cardiovascular examination or physical examination of precordium, we will get parasternal heap. Besides, pulmonary hypertension, if it persists, may lead to right ventricular hypertrophy, we have already discussed, and persistent right ventricular hypertrophy may ultimately lead to right ventricular failure. So right ventricular failure can be another important complication of mitral stenosis. Now because of right ventricular failure, it leads to ascites, then hepatomegaly, increased neck veins, then peripheral edema. So all the sign symptoms of right ventricular failure will be manifested because of complication. Mitral stenosis can complicate to right ventricular failure. Now all of us, we know when there is a right ventricular failure, by backward pressure theory it can also lead to left ventricular failure. Besides, as I told you that when the mitral stenosis becomes severe, it leads to the left atrial pressure rise, and because of high rise of left atrial pressure, it causes left atrial enlargement, which ultimately leads to left atrial hypertrophy. Now because of persistent left atrial enlargement, it affects the development of local ectopics in the left atrium, and which ultimately affect the electrical activity of the left atrium, and there is a development of atrial fibrillation. What is atrial fibrillation? Here we will see irregular pulse, and atria lose their synchronicity with the ventricles, and atria starts pumping or contracting at higher rate, which is not at synchronicity with the ventricle, and it is not under control of the SNO. It becomes independent, and because of that the contraction is of the atrium is ineffective, which also rises the left atrial pressure and weakens the left atrial muscle, and ultimately increase the risk of stasis of blood in the left atrium, and because of that there is the increased risk of clot formation or blood clot formation or thrombus formation in the left atrial chambers, which ultimately increase the risk of thromboembolic phenomena. That is, once the clot is formed in the left atrial chamber, it can be dislodged through systemic circulation into various parts of the body, especially in case of cerebral circulation, if it is undergo embolic effect on the cerebral musculature, it can lead to stroke or brain attack, also known as cerebrovascular accident. So cerebrovascular accident or stroke is another important complication of atrial fibrillation which can be because of mitral stenosis. So mitral stenosis can even lead to stroke or cerebrovascular accident or other thromboembolic phenomena also. So these are the various complications of mitral stenosis. So again I am telling, mitral stenosis can lead to left atrial enlargement, which leads to left atrial hypertrophy. Besides, there is an increase in the left atrial pressure, which ultimately leads to pulmonary hypertension and pulmonary edema. So dyspnea may be there, pulmonary capillary rupture may be there, leading to hemoptysis. Besides, there may be risk of right ventricular hypertrophy and right ventricular failure, which ultimately affect the systemic blood pressure and ultimately lead to left ventricular failure also. Besides, there may be increased risk of atrial fibrillation, which will increase the risk of congestive heart failure as well as thromboembolic phenomena. Even it may cause stroke also or cerebrovascular accidents. So these are the various complications of mitral stenosis. So when we try to manage mitral stenosis, so we have to manage the complication of mitral stenosis also. So patient of the mitral stenosis can also present with various complications of the mitral stenosis, and because of that the treatment modality is also to handle or prevent the complication as well as treat the various complication of the mitral stenosis. For example, we have to treat the pulmonary hypertension, we have to treat the right ventricular hypertrophy, we have to treat the right ventricular failure, and in case the patient is suffering from atrial fibrillation, we have to treat the atrial fibrillation with oral anticoagulants and keeping the INR at the level of 2 to 3. If the patient is having right ventricular failure, we have to treat the failure in condition. So these are the various complication as well as treatment modality. So treatment modality also depends on the complication of the mitral stenosis, and complication depends on the severity of the disease, and severity of the disease depends on the degree of mitral stenosis or severity of the stenosis or area of the orifice of the mitral stenosis. That's why Doppler echocardiography can diagnose the severity of the or complication of the mitral stenosis by measuring the transmitral gradient and also the left atrial pressure and left ventricular pressure gradient is another important gradient by which we can find out the severity of the disease. And when it comes to diagnosis, echocardiography play important role in diagnosis of the various complications. It can find out the left atrial hypertrophy, it can diagnose the thrombus formation, it can diagnose the right ventricular hypertrophy, right ventricular failure, pulmonary hypertension, etc. So echocardiography also plays an important role in diagnosis of the various complications of mitral stenosis. Thank you very much.